Hey everyone, Dr. David Clark. On today's video, I'm going to be explaining how gluten and gluten sensitivity can cause osteoporosis and osteopenia. All right, so to begin, we got to define a few terms like we always do. I mentioned osteoporosis and osteopenia. So what are those? Well, generally speaking, if you want to just think about it kind of broadly, it's reduced bone mineral density and kind of microstructural deterioration. And it can happen for a lot of different reasons, but what we're going to be talking about today is how gluten sensitivity can promote that. Now, to give you a little bit better definition, you really can't, by current guidelines, have osteopenia and osteoporosis at the same time. So it's kind of a spectrum. Basically, the way that they're diagnosed is they use what's called a dual energy X-ray absorptometry test, or DEXA, and they'll maybe use your femur, sometimes they'll use a wrist, and what they do is you get what's called a T-score and a Z-score, and a T-score looks at your bone mineral density compared to someone who has peak bone mineral density, and kind of the cutoff is if you're at 1 to 2.5 standard deviations below normal. That's kind of a mathematical thing. If you're 1 to 2.5 standard deviations below, that's considered osteopenia. And if you're worse than 2.5, that's considered osteoporosis. Now, a Z-score is another score you get, and that's really you kind of match to someone your same age and sex. So a Z-score that's minus 2.0 standard deviations or worse is basically below the expected range for your age, right? So that's kind of how those are described. Now, are there symptoms of osteoporosis and osteopenia? Not really, not until you break something. A very common first symptom of osteoporosis is a vertebral fracture. The problem is about two-thirds of vertebral fractures are silent. You don't know they're happening. But what can happen over time is people can develop that kind of a stooped posture, and I'm sure you've all seen someone who looks like this. That's probably someone that's had severe osteoporosis. And you can get osteoporosis from like long-term, you know, steroid use. You can get it from a malabsorption due to celiac disease, which we'll talk about in a second. But what I want to talk about is more of a autoimmune cause for osteoporosis and osteopenia. And gluten is the connection. So what is the connection? Well, osteocytes are little cells that make up our bones. And you can see on this graphic that I've got here, there's kind of these units of bone that we call osteons, and they're made up of these little, well, almost looks like a tree, right? Like if you cut a tree, you could see like the concentric circles, but there are osteocytes in there. Now, your immune system can attack those and destroy them. And if that happens, just like a tree that's starting to rot, it's going to become fragile and less dense and be prone to fractures. And that is what can happen if you have gluten sensitivity, because gluten antibodies can cross-react with osteocytes. So I've explained cross-reaction in other videos, and if you've seen this part, you're welcome to skip ahead, but I want to explain it again for those of you who don't know what cross-reaction is. Cross-reaction occurs when your immune system makes antibodies for one thing, but those antibodies can stick on another thing. Now, I always tell people that antibodies are like a post-it note, right? It's a post-it note that the immune system makes to stick onto something. Now, we have antibodies to lots of things floating around our body. A low level of that is totally normal. But when we start making like a lot of antibodies to something, that's generally when we have an autoimmune situation happening. So in gluten sensitivity, we are making antibodies to one or more pieces of wheat, right? So a lot of times I'll just use gluten sensitivity as sort of a broad term, but essentially what we're talking about is all the different pieces of wheat, right? There's gliadin, there's alpha gliadin, there's omega gliadin. There's lots of little pieces of it that you can have a problem with. Well, gliadin is the piece of wheat that if you have antibodies to, these antibodies for gliadin can stick onto your osteocytes and direct your immune system to go in and kill those osteocytes. And so what happens over time is you lose bone density, and kind of like a silent thief in the night, one day you have a trivial fall or a trivial injury, and you get a vertebral fracture, or you fracture your femur, or you fracture the head of your hip, or you fracture your pubic bones. And that is how gluten sensitivity can cause osteoporosis. Now, I want to give you guys an actual real-world case. So I'm going to switch over here in a second and show you the results of an antibody test I did on a 63-year-old woman, and here it goes. Okay, so this is just very quickly the results of a multiple tissue autoimmune panel that I did on a 63-year-old lady who had been complaining of bone loss in various different parts of the body, and osteoporosis and osteopenia. And based on her history, I said, you know what, we should run this test because I wonder if there's not an autoimmune cause for your bone loss. And this is a test that you can get done from Cyrix Labs. I do this test on a lot of folks. And yep, look right here, lo and behold, she has out of range osteocyte antibodies. Now she also happens to have out of range cytochrome P450 from liver cell antibodies, as well as asialoglycoside antibodies, that's a protein in nerves, and cerebellum antibodies. Just so happens these other three antibodies are all cross-reactors with gluten, just the way that osteocyte antibodies are cross-reactors with gluten. Now, it could be that if this lady avoided gluten for 6 to 8 months or longer, that these antibody levels might normalize. But we don't know. Time is going to have to tell. But this lets us know that for her, osteocyte antibodies are probably what is the main mechanism for her kind of overall osteopenia, not simply like a calcium problem or a vitamin D problem. So that's a good example of how one person's osteoporosis and osteopenia was for sure caused by these osteocyte antibodies. Now again, only time is going to tell if we can regain some of that density, but that's a really good example of cross-reactivity. She had multiple antibodies, all known to be cross-reactors, all of which I'm making other videos on. And the treatment for that is, guess what? It's a 100% gluten-free diet and a little bit more. There's a few more things you have to do, but I'm not going to go into that because that's just a little too complicated. But the reason I bring this up is if you have osteoporosis and you have osteopenia, you might want to make sure you're working with someone who can check you for these antibodies and knows how to handle that situation, because taking vitamin D or taking calcium won't stop this problem if it's autoimmune. Like in that particular patient's case, she had this developing bone loss throughout her body. Well, that doesn't sound like regular osteopenia, right? That sounds more like something else is going on. And that's, of course, what clued me in. So to sum up today's video, gluten sensitivity can cause osteoporosis and osteopenia because of cross-reaction between gluten antibodies, gliadin antibodies, and osteocytes. So make sure you're working with someone who can investigate that appropriately for you and knows what to do if they find it, because it's a little more complicated than I'm making it sound. So just make sure you're working with someone that understands about this.